There are a number of mistakes that people make over and over on keto. Here are the five most common ones. We will start at the bottom of this list with keto mistake number five, eating too many carbs. Now, keto is a very low carb diet when you are usually aiming to eat below 20 grams of net carbs per day. That's not a lot, and it's very easy to get too many carbs. For example, one medium-sized banana can contain 24 grams of net carbs. That's more than the full daily recommendation. One large can of beer can contain 20 grams of carbs. One large cup of coffee latte can also contain 20 grams of carbs. There is plenty of sugar and milk. It is super easy to get higher in carbs, so what can you do to avoid it? Use our guides, including the visual guides, to learn. You can use our recipes and meal plans, and that way you don't have to count at all. Just buy the food, cook it and eat it, and you will automatically be successful at staying low carb. Mistake number four, fear of fat. A lot of people start low carb keto diet and they understand that the point is to reduce carbs, but they might not see to need to increase their fat intake. They might even fear fat, thinking it's going to raise their cholesterol and clog up their arteries. Don't fear fat. Modern science has convincingly shown that old fear of fat was a mistake. The bottom line is that natural fat is fine to eat. In fact, on the low carb diet, fat is important as it will be the main fuel of your body. Either you have to eat or your body will burn its stored fat. Now you might be thinking that you would prefer your body to burn its stored fat, and to some extent that's okay, but you will still have to eat enough fat to feel satisfied and good. If you go very low carb and low fat, the risk is that you will feel hungry and miserable, starving even, and then you might quit. Eat enough fat that you feel good and enough protein to go with it. Ideally, get a lot of your fat from natural nutritious food like meat, eggs, fish, avocados, but feel free to add some butter, olive oil or high fat sources too. If you're hungry, eat more fat. And remember, fat is your friend. Let's move on to keto mistake number three, snacking and unnecessary eating. On a keto diet, satiety usually goes way up. You will not get hungry as fast, so you will simply not need to eat as often. Use this to your advantage, especially if you are trying to lose weight. When your body is busy burning fat, when even your brain is burning fat through ketones, and when you are feeling fine, don't mess with what's working so well. So you might only have to eat two or three times a day, or perhaps even just once a day, to stay happy and satisfied. And in between those meals, your body will be burning body fat all the time. If you instead eat just because you are used to eat at a specific time, or just because there is a snack lying around, well, then your body is going to burn that fat that you just ate instead of your body fat. And that will slow down weight loss and slow down reversal of diabetes 2 and other health improvements. Common things that people tend to snack on despite not being hungry includes nuts and cheese. Not to speak of low carb cookies and chocolate and fat bombs. Make those an occasional indulgence. Avoiding unnecessary eating and only eating when hungry can result in some intermittent fasting, saving both time and money. And all you might lose is some excess weight. Moving on to keto mistake number two, misunderstanding ketones. Is higher ketones usually better? And if so, is everything that raises ketones a good thing? A lot of people believe that when starting a keto diet, but it's actually a mistake. We have talked about ketones in earlier episodes of this video course and how to measure them in your blood, urine or breath. A stricter keto diet usually raises ketone levels, as does fasting or extra exercise. In fact, anything that lowers insulin levels in the body tends to increase ketone levels, and that is usually a good thing. However, there are other things that can raise ketone levels without lowering insulin, and those could be bad for you. You can eat a lot of extra fat that you don't need and your ketones might go up, but that's hardly a good thing. For example, drinking MCT oil or bulletproof coffee several times a day, that's just going to add a lot of extra fat and ketones to your system, perhaps overload it. It will certainly slow down weight loss. Another example is ketone supplements. Now, this might raise your ketone levels, and under certain conditions, they might be beneficial for mental or physical performance, but they will definitely not help you lose weight or reverse disease. So don't make this mistake. Higher ketones is not necessarily better, and strange supplements to raise your ketone levels are not helpful for your health or weight. Finally, the number one mistake on keto, salt deficiency. Have you heard it before? That's right, don't get deficient in salt on keto. It's so common and results in people feeling tired, lethargic, getting headaches, and all kinds of other symptoms. If you want a reminder, go back and listen to part 4 of this course again. Don't fear salt. You need enough salt, especially on keto. And those were the top 5 mistakes on keto. And with this, we wrap up our keto course for beginners. You can no longer consider yourself a newbie on the subject. You have learned all the basics about the keto diet. Maybe you have even started eating this way and you are experiencing how it feels for you. If you haven't started yet, what are you waiting for? You know all you need to know. And remember that at BodyTime, we will be here to help you along the way, bringing you updated information about low carb and keto, always based on scientific evidence. We want to make low carb as simple as possible. I also want to remind you that if you need personalized medical assistance, especially if you suffer from any health issue and you are taking medications, it is important that you are supported by your doctor who can track your progress and help you reduce or even remove your medications. For example, medications for blood pressure or blood sugar. Thank you for choosing to take this course and see you soon in another one. If you enjoyed this video and want to hear from me again, be sure to hit the subscribe button before you go. If you have any questions, comment below, give me a like, and just follow me to don't miss one of my videos on YouTube, Instagram, and Facebook. To your success, your health and wealth mentor.